Welcome to On the Beat, the show that goes anywhere and does anything to find Chicagoans having fun. With your host, AJ. Yaya Townsend. And boards ran by Peter Ortega. This is On the Beat.
Hello, guys, and welcome to the first and hopefully not the only episode of On the Beat, the show that goes anywhere and does anything to find Chicagoans having fun. We are your hosts. I am Petty Murphy.
And I'm Yaya. Hey, how's it going? So on our very first episode of On the Beat, we're discussing a serious issue that's been concerning citizens of the city of Chicago. And today we have our lovely co-host and classmate, Miss Keena. Thank you for joining us
today.
So let's get right into it. So, according to the Chicago Tribune, and I quote, Chicago police officials on Thursday took the highly unusual step of calling together a dozen community activists to update them on two death investigations and warn them about unsubstantiated information being spread throughout social media. Superintendent Eddie Johnson convened in the meeting in the wake of the rumors that as many as six women had been snatched off the West Side streets and that one serial predator was responsible. Somehow the community has linked all six, and there's just no evidence of that, Johnson said. That's what he said. Then the community calls us with bogus tips. They think they're helping. Those 1,000 tips are unrelated. We have to chase all those down. So pretty much what's going on is there's been a string of kidnappings of black women on the south and west sides of the city of Chicago. And rumors, now they're being called rumors. Rumors are is that there is one person responsible for this. So people have been a little bit on edge and doing things to take precautionary measures to make sure that they stay safe. And now police are saying that these are all unrelated. These are all isolated individual incidents and that there is not one serial killer because there's no evidence of it. However, I think that it's just a little bit too coincidental in the ways that these women are being found.
I agree.
Yeah, so I wanted to discuss with you guys, what are some things that we can do to take precautionary measures to make sure that we stay safe on the streets, to make sure that our women and our children stay safe?
I definitely think traveling in pairs, having things like mace. If you have a gun license, I would highly recommend it at this time, just because this is such a serious situation.
Carry
that with you. And just letting your family and friends know where you are at all times. And watch your surroundings, definitely. I know a lot of us walk and text, we have headphones on, we're not really paying attention, but just, you know.
Absolutely.
Be on watch.
And you know what? I'm a victim of that. I'm guilty of that, I should say. Like, I always have headphones on. I'm always on my phone doing some type of promo or working on something or listening to YouTube or something. Like, a lot of times our cellular devices does cause our heads to be in the clouds a little bit when we're on the street, and I think that that's definitely one thing. I like the buddy system thing.
Yes, definitely.
That you had brought up. Like, I think that it's really good to travel in pairs or travel in groups if you can. I think that it would be wise to, like, communicate with people. Like, what I do is I tell people where I am, where I'm headed to, and who I'm with. Mm-hmm. And, you know, even if I'm texting my BFF, or my mother, I make sure that somebody knows where I am and where I'm going, just in case I don't make it there, they can retrace my steps for me and figure it out. It's a scary situation.
And it is scary, and also I learned about a lot of this from social media, so I think we need to, as a community, keep each other up to date with the latest, whether it be through social media, I mean, whatever avenue you choose, but Twitter definitely got the word out to me. Mm-hmm. And I further investigated, just like a quick Google search and read some news articles about what was happening. So definitely, as information comes out, keep each other updated.
Not only that, for the people that don't have those connections, can't walk in pairs, try to walk on the main street. I mean, if walk on the main street, there's a big population of people that if something does happen, there's a possibility of a police being called or something like that, because you don't want to be anywhere where there are not any witnesses.
Absolutely.
Something happened to you.
And to piggyback off on that, the main streets, I also had that tip years ago when I was in college. I would be coming home very late, and a friend of mine said, you need to stop taking those side streets late at night, because I live in East Garfield Park. And a friend of mine told me, you need to stop taking those side streets so late at night, because those side streets are not well lit. Usually office buildings and commercial buildings are on the main street, and a lot of those buildings have security cameras on the outside, so they see what's going outside. So that's another advantage of using main streets to get home. It might take a little bit longer. However, if in the event that anything happens, these security cameras can catch what's going on. You know what I'm saying? So and these main streets are well lit. So you guys stay safe. You guys do take the precautionary measures to make sure that we all take care of each other. So
on our next segment of On the Beat, we took to the streets of Chicago to get some of our fellow Chicagoans a little fun question to answer. It's time for On the Street.
Should be fun.
Hello guys, and welcome to another episode of On The Beat. I am your host, Antoine Davis, and you guys' name are?
I'm Caitlin.
I'm Abby.
And I'm Pat.
Pat? Yeah. Pleasure to meet you guys. So, okay, we're going to ask you guys some questions. You have 5 minutes to answer these questions.
5 minutes?
Yes. Who is the current president of the United States?
Barack Obama!
Oh my God, who? I have the guest here. What's your name?
Mickey,
okay.
Yeah.
Ooh, that's a pretty name.
Thank
okay,
you.
Anyways, we're gonna get started with these questions. Let's see how smart you are. Right. Who is the current president of the United States?
Trump.
Yes, yes. Ding, ding, ding. Okay, there we go. Okay, who is the current president of the United States?
That would be Donald Trump.
Okay, ding, ding, ding. There we go, 1 point on the block. Who is the current president of the United States?
Trump.
Okay, okay. Okay, what gets sharper the more you use it?
Okay, what gets sharper?
Your brain.
There you go. Oh yeah, that was right, that was right. Okay.
I'm glad y'all are like,
what gets sharper the more you use it?
Your wit.
What gets sharper the more you use it?
Well, to me, your mind.
We'll count that. There are 30 cows in the field, 28 chicken. How many didn't?
How many dinners?
No.
I'm sorry.
There are 20 cows in the field.
20 cows in the field.
28 chicken. How many didn't?
28 chicken. What?
Last question. Okay. There are 30 cows in the field, 28 chicken. How many didn't?
I'm confused what they didn't do.
Two.
Next question.
Okay. There are 30 cows in the field.
30 cows? I thought you said there were chickens.
Wait, what? Okay. Think about it before you answer it.
10.
There you go.
30 cows, 28 chickens.
Hey, Dad, come here.
There are 30 cows in the field, 28 chicken. How many didn't?
10.
There you go.
Okay.
Oh, 20 of them ate the chicken.
There you go. Okay, now, there we go.
Okay. That was our On the Street segment. That was hilarious. I can't wait to do more of those. So, guys, we're going to talk a little bit about some sports. So,
hot topic
number two. So, joining us today thank you for joining us. So, I'll let you take it away.
Okay, so for today's topic, we're going to discuss, where do you think LeBron James will be traded to?
Houston.
Or where is he heading?
He's going to Houston.
You think he's
going
to Houston?
He's going to Houston. You know why?
I disagree, but let me ask you, why is he going to Houston?
Because
why do you think?
I'm
going
to outline 3 points why he's going to Houston. Number one, he said this in a recent interview. He said he wants to play with teammates that have a high basketball IQ. And you think, who's down there in Houston?
Wow.
Chris Paul. Who's Chris Paul? One of the best point guards of all time. Not to mention, one of LeBron James' best friends. That's point number one. Point number two, look at what Houston did last year without him. You just have Chris Paul and James Harden, which by themselves almost beat Golden State in the West Finals. Think about that. And thirdly, come on, man. Like, he's not going to L.A. There's too many young players over there.
Where do you think he's going?
Let me hit you guys with the facts. LeBron James is going to L.A. He's going to build his own super team.
No.
We all know LeBron James likes to run his own thing. So, in my opinion, LeBron James is going to L.A. First of all, Paul George and Kawhi Leonard wants to go to L.A. So,
hold
if they
on,
go to L.A.
Hold on. There's no confirmed reports that Paul George is going to L.A. He might just re-sign with OKC.
No, not going to happen. The way Westbrook is over there playing, he's not going back over there to OKC.
So you're saying Westbrook is what? You're saying like no one can play with Russell?
No one can play with Westbrook. He's a stat stuffer.
I mean, stat stuffer or not, he's talented. Like, 2 straight years averaging triple-double. It's never been done before. Ever.
I don't
want to play with Russell Westbrook.
Matter of fact, I'd give somebody that can play with Westbrook LeBron James. You know what Russell Westbrook is? A mini LeBron James.
A mini LeBron.
Yes.
That's
with
a strong
better stats. With
that's
better
a
stats.
Strong comparison.
Am I wrong, though?
I think you are.
How am I wrong?
Okay. First off, let's look at this. And we don't need to compare players that play different positions, even though the NBA is moving towards positionless basketball in and of itself. But Westbrook is no LeBron. I will say this because, number one, I'm not a LeBron James fan. But from a pure standpoint of being a fan of the game, LeBron James does things I've never seen done before by anybody except Kobe Bryant and Michael Jordan. He carries subpar teams to the NBA Finals year after year since leaving Miami. And that's not a knock against Kyrie Irving, because Kyrie's a superstar in his own right. But you look at who they had this past season. Your second option is Kevin Love, somebody who, despite being an all-star, to me doesn't play like an all-star, because in Minnesota he was just another case of bad team, good stats. You get to Cleveland, you're not replicating that same type of production that you had in Minnesota. You're a little close, but you're nowhere near where you were.
So you telling me not to compare LeBron and Westbrook, right?
You can't.
Okay, let me tell you something. Don't you ever, ever compare LeBron James to Michael Jordan and Kobe Bryant. And let me tell you why. You know what LeBron lacks that Kobe and Michael Jordan had?
A killer instinct.
A killer instinct.
But I'm not comparing the instinct. I'm comparing...
What does Westbrook do all 48 minutes of an NBA basketball game? He works. He hustles. He grinds it out. He is the only player on his team that does that a whole 48 minutes. LeBron James don't even do that. Am I right or wrong?
Here's where you're not getting it that, though, man. Russell Westbrook has to do those things. Like, if you look at statistics, Westbrook's usage rate is the highest in the league. 2 years in a row, besides
Westbrook had teammates he could have passed the ball to. He had Paul George and he had Carmelo Anthony,
who both slumped. Melo's hit a brick wall. Much as I love Carmelo Anthony, that's one of my
favorite players. They didn't pass the ball to Carmelo Anthony enough in that game.
Melo didn't hit shots. Melo can't hit shots. Melo is not Melo anymore. Melo is someone.
If they gave the ball to Melo and let him do what he wanted to do.
No.
He would have found a rhythm.
It didn't work in New York. It's not going to work in OKC.
In New York,
Paul George lost his jump shot at the worst time he could possibly lose a jump shot. Melo hasn't played at an all-star level since, 2014-15-ish? I don't see where you're going with this.
Man.
First off, OKC is better off getting rid of Melo than keeping him. Because first off, that his cap hit is way too high for a player of his subpar production and his unwillingness to commit himself into the team culture and to accept the bench role for a better player.
Okay.
So where do you think they're gonna go? Where do you think he's gonna go if not Houston?
LeBron? I'm saying he's making his own team. I'm saying he's going to LA, he's gonna go to the Lakers, and he's gonna build his own super team. LeBron likes to be the man.
Work.
LeBron has to be the man for the team to work. And Miami, when they won a championship, who was the man? LeBron James.
Dwayne Wade.
They won their first championship in Cleveland, who was the man? It was not Kyrie Irving.
Who bailed him out to win that first championship?
Nobody bailed him out.
So you're saying Kyrie Irving didn't hit that clutch shot?
Kyrie Irving did not hit that three-point shot, they
would have
still
lost.
Won by 1 point. Let me tell you why. LeBron James blocked the shot. And he almost dunked on Draymond Green. He went to the foul line and he made a free throw. People forget that.
No.
Yes, they won by 4 points.
You need to go back and rewatch that game.
They won by 4 points. Off Kyrie Irving's three-pointer and LeBron James's subpar, he tried to dunk the ball. He went to the free throw line at the end. I remember because he hurt his wrist.
You need to rewatch that game, sir. We were talking about different games here. But, I'll say this. LeBron James is not going to L.A. because, number one, Magic Johnson isn't going to let somebody just come in and take over the whole team. That's not going to happen, number one. Number two, L.A. is a young team still growing. And the last thing you need to do is bring in somebody who, as you've seen, we all saw the J.R. Smith blunder in game one of the finals this year. We saw LeBron James' reaction, and J.R. Smith is a veteran. 10-plus years in this league. He's a seasoned veteran. You're not – how you think he's going to respond when these young kids make a mistake that they're going to make? Because a majority of that roster is under the age of 25 years old. So these are still kids learning how to play the game. They're still learning.
Okay, so we're gonna come back to this maybe sometime in July, and we're gonna talk about this topic because this is something big. But now we're gonna leave, and we're gonna I'm sorry guys. Okay, this is our first episode of On the Beat.
Yes.
And that will be all.
And thank you for joining us, and thank you, Deshaun. Make sure you guys catch his sports show on WindyCityUnderground.com every Friday at 11 a.m.
11 to 12.
11
to 12,
the catch up.
We're on Chicago Sportsland Radio every Friday morning, 11 to 12. Check
you
us
got
out.
It. And join us next week when we go to battle with our Heralds versus Uncle Remus's taste test. Yes, we eating chicken!
See you guys next week!
And stay on beat!
Welcome to On the Beat, the show that goes anywhere and does anything to find Chicagoans having fun. With your hosts, AJ, Yaya Townsend, Sean, boards ran